smell around here, you can't help thinking that's not water running down the side of the road. It stinks. Nice and steady. Now again, we're going uphill here, and I don't know if it looks uphill to you guys. It's not hugely steep, but it's quite steep. Ooh. Still going uphill. Only slightly now. That's us at the top. Crikey. See, look, you can't imagine this road gets used very often. This is the sort of road that I end up plotting by accident when I'm out with my mates on our road bikes, and I say we've come on a little mini break to Devon, and I'll go, oh, I'll plot as a route, and I'll plot the route, and I always manage to add in one road like this, and it's normally, we'll be going down it on a rainy day, and we're all on great big expensive road bikes, and we get to the other end, and everyone else is like, fucking hell, because they've been shitting it all the way down, thinking they're going to fall off. smell all this bracken again. It's quite a nice smell. You wouldn't want it in your house. As your air freshener. But it's kind of a nice smell because it's a countryside smell. Spider's web tickling my nose. Yeah, it is, isn't it? We going right?
Yeah, right,
up
here.
We are all there. Not much of a gate. Put one of these on your Christmas list.
What is it, a Garmin?
It's a Garmin Montana. They're quite expensive, they're hundreds of pounds, but as we're riding around now, it's memorising our route, and then I can save that as a track and call it whatever you want, Somerset 2, and then when you reload it, it doesn't look like a little tiny line, it shows up like a pink line, like on a normal sat nav, and then you can just re-follow your route.
An ordinary Garmin, but it can use it as a normal sat-nav as well. Yeah. I could do with getting another one. Right, that's where we are, I think. So the next lane is just down here on the left, I think. And that takes us all the way to
Torrington.
Virtually to Torrington, yeah. About another three, four lanes to go.
If you're exploring, you've got to have a paper map really to lay it out and go, that's where we want to be, because you're only ever seeing a tiny 2-inch square of a map.
If you're on a, you've planned your route, we'll do that one, that one, that
yeah. Or like when we went to Wales, there was a lady from the Oxford TRF group who, before we went, she sent us like 7 or 8 GPX files and said, these are the 7 or 8 normal track like routes we take. And then you can load them on everyone, which we did, load them on everyone's sat nav before you go. And then the night before, you're sitting in the pub and you all have a chat and go, let's try that one. And it's, you know, you've all got it on the map. It's 150 miles and you'll just...
Yeah, and you can look at the map the night before to see if
it's... Yeah, yeah.
And then just follow the route on that map.
It's just nice having so many lanes.
It is, isn't it?
You remember the days of Bedfordshire, don't you? Aspley Guys Golf Course and round the back of Centre Parks, and you've pretty much done it.
Where's the next one?
Thank you. but it's quite overgrown. Just saw a piece of tarmac there, so this used to be a road once. It just shows you how they can deteriorate when they're just left. So all that's left is this tiny strip down the middle, and the rest is slowly being crumbled away by Land Rovers and farm vehicles, I guess.
Up that one. I don't know how we missed it.
Are we going back up it?
I don't really wonder with that woman there with the dog.
She's blackberry picking.
Yeah. So let's just see if I'm getting it. The other routes are that way, but I'm not sure where that road is.